Something about the story of the crescendo. The first time I met Bernard was in 1996. And okay, I was listening to his 20 centimeter because he just started his company, and the first product he made was the 20 centimeter drive unit with copper foil coil. Afterwards it was also available in silver foil coil. Okay, I sat there and listened to it, and I was totally impressed by what I heard, and so I asked if I could take a pair with me. And well, yeah, that was all very complicated, but after some time I could buy a pair, and I paid him and left. And so I went home and tried to make something what was interesting. So I started with MDF. You never use MDF for this kind of loudspeakers because it deadens all the beauty. So one day after some trials, Bernard told me, Hans, you should try spruce, plain spruce. And so I went to a wood trading company and bought some spruce and started to make cabinets totally of spruce and Oregon pine. The front panel is made of Oregon, and the side panels and the top panel is spruce. Spruce is used for violins, guitars, shortly for string instruments. It is the best wood for this purpose. And Oregon pine, the same. Oregon pine is, by example, also used for organ pipes, pipes which are in organs. Okay. This was a lot of work because I had to make 4 millimeter thick panels and blocks of spruce. So we had to saw it into slices and then glue the slices together and sand it, etc., etc. And then one day there was a finished cabinet, and I sat down with a friend and we listened to it, and yeah, this was bringing everything alive. Compared to the MDF, there was subtlety, there was a very nice sound in the instruments. It was very natural sounding, and everything we missed was there. So that was the beginning of the series of crescendos we made. But the only problem to connect it to plain wood is the risk on cracks. And after some time, when you the climate is changing, you bring speakers to other countries, there's always a risk on lower humidity in the air, lower the relative humidity. And it dries the wood, and there is a risk on cracks. So, unfortunately, I should prefer to make only these cabinets because it are the best. But practice showed that people are complaining about a little crack, and commercially, it is a lot of work. It takes about 60 hours in total, I think, to make one pair of cabinets. So we decided to do it a little bit different. And on request, it is possible for us still to produce this kind of spruce cabinets, but normally we use special plywood like birch and saiba. That's another wood species, veneered with veneers, a choice. Yeah. Okay.